what's up? Mark from Wandering Souls. Back with a new update. This time a CD update. I got me here a stack of CDs to show you guys. Different kind of genres. Yeah, let's dive into this. The first one I want to show you is the third album by De La Morte. This is Home Sweet Hell. An album I didn't heard a lot in the past, but I came across it a lot, especially I really liked the cover for this album. I finally saw it on Marktplaats, which is such a sort of Dutch eBay site, for a few euros. I thought, let's grab it. I've been looking to this a lot and never took the chance to buy it, and just grabbed it. It's some death metal from Sweden, old school style. Not the typical death metal. Yes, there are Entombed influence a lot, like the older work, but also the new work. The death and roll sound is also appealing in appearing in some of the songs. It makes it a bit of a diverse release, musical wise. Interesting sound. Only it took me some time to get used to the vocals of this band. They are not the typical death grunt, they're mere the death and roll sound of what LG Petrov did in Entombed, so to speak. Yeah, it makes it a bit diverse. There's also some stoner influences in some of the songs, like in Supercharged, for example, if I'm not mistaken. Interesting release. This was released in 1999 by Osmos Productions, and this is the third album, like I said. The band quickly split up after they released, after this CD they released an EP and then they split up. I don't know why, but yeah, probably got fed up with making music or something, I don't know. Yeah, that's the booklet. CD looks like this. And of course then we have the back with the song titles. Yeah, third album by this band. They say it's the best album, so yeah, I'm not really intended to get their other stuff. Not that I don't like this band. It's okay. I can you get used to this, but it's not a release I gonna spin over and over again. But I like this once in a while. Pretty decent death metal, but a different role kind of music. If you like that kind of stuff, you probably will dig this. Me, on the other hand, I rather heard the early work of Entombed. That's is kind of the way I think about it. Over to the next one, also one from Marktplaats. This is Autopsy with X of the Unspeakable, and this is the reissue of their third album from 1992, and this one came with a lot of bonus tracks. As you guys can see, there's the Fiend for Blood EP, which is added to this, and some live tracks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 live tracks added to this release. That's pretty cool, I think. Only one CD, so yeah, it's stacked with stuff. Nice reissue in a digipack. I rather would have had a jewel case, but it looked pretty good. The owner, or the previous owner, did really take good care of it. Even came in a plastic sleeve, so that's how good the owner took care of it. yeah, it's like new. So yeah, thank you for that, guy. I don't know. Yeah. Anyways, third album, like I said, raw death metal, old school death metal, some doom hints here. The first songs actually start really doomy, and then it gets up. After the first intro parts, they get over to the faster, more up-tempo stuff. So they get a nice mixture in this. yeah, Autopsy is doing what Autopsy does always. So yeah, you can't go wrong here. Great old school death metal. Check it out, Autopsy with Acts of the Unspeakable. Next one. I bought at Drykov Records, and this was my number one last year, so a lot of people already know what this is. This is the latest album by Yellow Eyes, Immersion Trance Reverie. Finally got a physical copy of this. It took a while to get here, actually. I don't know why it took so long, but definitely glad that's here. Great stuff. Booklet is just like a lyric sheet, nothing special. The back is even has nothing on it, so that's how simple it is here. What I don't like, that the sleeve comes in like this, of the CD comes in like this in the sleeve. Rather would have a sleeve around it, or it's actually tray like the Autopsy one. This one could cause some scratches and stuff like that, but it's in good condition, it's like new. So yeah, see what happens in as time passes by. Yeah, this is some amazing black metal from New York. Really great stuff. The sound is harsh, raw, not top production, but the songs are really, really great. Great riffs, great harsh, high-pitched screams. And yeah, I really like the atmosphere, the sound samples around it. It makes the album really complete. I think the album should have been a lot better, even if the production was a lot better, I think. But yeah, in this way it still has something. It has a lot of atmosphere on it, and I really, really dig that. Great stuff. If you don't know Yellow Eyes, get on it, guys. If you're a black metal fanatic, this is a must hear. Immersion Trance Reverie by Yellow Eyes, released in 2017. It should be still available, but guys, it takes a while because it gets overseas, or you must live there, then it's probably be faster than at your house. But yeah, I'm in Europe, so what can you do? Great release, Yellow Eyes, go check it out. Hope it will focus so you guys can read it. If not, sorry. Great stuff. Go check it out. Next up, I release to complete a discography a bit. Almost complete, only a few EPs left, singles. I managed to pick up Hearse by Marduk. So, yeah. An EP I was missing in my collection. Only two songs. A song Hearse, which was taken from the album World Funeral. What happened with the light, guys? Fucking hell. Anyways, and this next song, the after, is Phantasm, and I think that's a cover song, if I'm not mistaken. I forgot the band. Too bad which band it was, but it doesn't matter. Released prior to the World Funeral album, so you know what kind of lineup this is. Really great stuff. Fast-paced Marduk material. Definitely worth checking out this EP. Glad to have it in my collection. So hers by Marduk. Next up is also a kind of a compilation. This is Nazgul with Black Seed. I hope you guys can see this, but there is something on the back, but it's really hard to see black on black printed, just like the CD. Only that is just a little bit better to see. Track listing. And let's open the booklet here. Nazgul is a black metal band from Australia. Really great raw stuff. This compilation contains the Black Sea EP, of course, which is released in 1998. Also contains their first demo from 1994 and two live tracks. Really decent raw black metal stuff, especially raw. The earlier stuff is more raw than the EP even. But yeah, really nice atmosphere, some keyboard sounds to add more atmosphere to the stuff, to the guitar work, and yeah, really great stuff. Definitely can recommend you this band. I will try to pick up some more because I want to hear some more stuff from this great Australian band. Yeah, what can I say more? Just check it out, guys, and let me know what you think. If you are into black metal, raw black metal, just give it a try. Next up, some completely different. A classic I really wanted to have in my collection for a long time, but never took the time to actually pick it up. And of course, I was browsing on Marktplaats, and what did I find? Horrified with Repulsion with Horrified, sorry. Classic grindcore release. This is a reissue, of course, because the first issue will be priceless, anyways, big price. Yeah, great stuff. This album is had a lot of stuff added to it. Disc 2 contains some rarities. Demo material, rehearsal material, the Crucifixion EP, live material, yeah, it's all on there. The total of 30 tracks on CD2, and CD1 has 18, so it's 48 tracks. And I think, what did I pay for it? I don't even know, like $8 or something, I don't know. Pretty cool stuff. Really highly recommended, old school grindcore. Definitely worth picking up. Yeah, and the other disc is like the same, so I'm not gonna bother showing that. It's in here. You guys should have guessed. The booklet looks very cool. Very well taken care of, a lot of stories, lyrics, and other kind of pictures and flyers and other kind of stuff in here, all about the band in their early days. Yeah, in the vein of old Napalm Death, that kind of stuff, then you definitely dig this. One of the earlier grindcore bands, together with Napalm Death, Agathocles, I think, yeah, and some others, but definitely really early stuff, like mid-80s grindcore, so that's how old the material actually is. Yeah, great release, go check it out if you don't know. Repulsion with Horrified, definitely highly recommended. Great stuff. Then the last two, this second to last is No Stars Upon the Bridge by Halotar, which is an atmospheric doom death metal band from Finland. really amazing stuff. And this contains the guitar player of Swallow the Sun, Trees of Eternity, and the vocalist of Amorphis. Released by SWAT Records, this is the only release so far. It was released last year, and it's actually a kind of a tribute to the passed away girlfriend of the guitar player Aaliyah, which was also the singer of Trees of Eternity. And she's also can be heard on this release in one song. And there's another female vocalist, and I was really stoked that she was also on here. That is Heike Lanhans from Draconian, is also on this release. So I was really stoked, and when I heard this on YouTube, I thought I must have that CD. So I bought it immediately. Great, great stuff. Really great, great grunts, nice clean vocals, nice female vocals, nice atmosphere by the music. Really amazing stuff. The band itself. Yeah, definitely worth checking out, and I'm really curious what they're gonna do next. With the next album, if there comes one, of course. Definitely worth checking out. If you don't know Halatar with No Stars Upon the Bridge, definitely go check it out. Especially like the song My Mistake, which is featuring like Heike Langhans. Raven Song Mirrors is a good song. And the last one, Dreams Upon Burned Down. Really great, great atmospheric song. Great, great release. Check out Halatar with No Stars Upon the Bridge, released by SWAT Records. And SWAT means black. Hey Bono, SWAT. Anyways, and the last one I want to show you guys is the new release by Sorcerer, also released last year, I think. Yes. Released by Metal Blade, and this is some really fantastic epic doom metal from Sweden. If you like Candlemass, that kind of bands, go grab this one. Really awesome, awesome stuff. This is the second album, The Crowning of the Fire King. When I heard the first album, In the Shadow of the Inverted Cross, which was released in 2015, I was really impressed. The band was started in the 80s, lived for 4 years and then split up, and yeah, rose from the grave in 2010, and in 2015 they released a new album, actually the first album, the debut album, and it was amazing stuff. So I was really stoked for the second album, and it came in this form, nice digibook format. Really nice pictures, lyrics. Really great, great looking book. A lot of lyrics, band pictures, of course. Yeah, great stuff. This is the CD itself. And the back, of course. Like I said, really nice epic doom metal, slow paced music. Here and there's an up tempo parts to make it more diverse. Nice riffing, and really like the nice clean vocals by what's the guy called? So how is the guy? What's the name? Anders Engberg. I think his name is. Is this guy, he's the vocalist. He does an amazing job on the vocals. Really nice clean vocals. Like I said, if you like stuff like Candlemass, you can't go wrong here. Early Black Sabbath. Yeah, in that kind of vein, you definitely will dig this. Great, great stuff. Highly, highly recommended. That's it. 8 CDs I've shown you guys. Next update will be again 8 CDs. So look forward to that. I will leave link in the description, down below in the description, for so you can listen to those releases I shown you just yet. Yeah, great, great stuff. Go check it out, guys. Really worth checking out, bands. I hope to see you guys in the next video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up or subscribe. Really, really appreciate it. I'm thinking about doing a giveaway, but I want to have more subscribers for that. So guys, please help me out. Let's get past the 150 border. That would be nice. I would really appreciate that. I'm now around 145 or something like that. So some subscribers more, I wouldn't mind. Anyways, thank you for watching, liking and supporting, and I hope to see you guys with the next video. Thank you, take care, and have a nice day.